You wanted some easy automations for your social media or content creation process in general? I got you covered. That's exactly what I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to show you three easy, simple automations you can implement now to automate your content creation process. Hey everybody, I'm Yvonne Heimann and I'm a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. And today we are finally talking automations. Now, if you have watched my content creation videos, you have seen the ClickUp setup that I'm talking about today already. If not, go watch the video because you're gonna need this. Now, there is a lot of things that are going on when it comes to content creation. And today I'm only gonna talk about three easy automations to get you started. So if you want to see and hear more about automations, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you can join the conversation and don't miss upcoming videos. Today, I'm going to get you started with three really simple but major impact automations for your content creation process right here in ClickUp. And I don't care if it's social media content, if it's YouTube content, whatever it is, I'm going to show you based on my YouTube folder in the template that you can get right down there in the description. You can grab all of this ready for you to go. And today I'm going to show you how these automations have made my life easier and can make your life easier too. Automation number one is just an easy automation that adds additional information to your task and stuff in general that you know you're going to need just by dumping in your content into this process. So let's head on over to my ClickUp and I'll show you what I mean by that and how that automation works. As you can see right here, this is my YouTube folder. You've seen this before if you watched my videos on content creation. YouTube, YouTube idea list, in the works list, published list. I'm not going to dive into the setup. Just go grab the video, watch it. It's all there. As you can see, this is the video that we are recording right now. And the moment I hit enter, things are going to happen. Ta-da! We created a task. Come on, baby. Where's the magic? The magic is happening right here in automations, and you can take this as far as you want to. In my case, when I get ready and have researched a new YouTube video and it's ready to do, I always know I need to be assigned, it needs to be tagged with YouTube, and a couple of things need to happen. So with that, when a task is created in here, one of the first thing that happens is we are setting the custom field to the online profile YouTube so that I know this is YouTube content. Now, one thing I need to point out here, this is happening in the YouTube folder. So all of these automations only apply to the YouTube folder. If you want specific automations to apply for the whole space, you need to go one level up. Now, another thing that should happen in here, and let's go create it, is right when a task gets created right here in that YouTube folder, I want the assignee to be me because all the videos start with me. That easy. Now, every time I create a task, first of all, it gets marked in my online profile custom field, which is right here. So now what happens every time I create a new task in here, I get assigned because I'm the first one that needs to deal with this. The online profile has been set to YouTube and you can add any other things you might want to. You can add your YouTube video process, workflow, subtasks. That's a mouthful. So you can apply a task template right away. You can add any kind of custom fields you might be using in here, all kinds of stuff. What are the same things and data points that have to happen every single time you create a task right here in your YouTube folder and make them happen automatically? Don't have to type them in every single time. So if they are always the same, automate that stuff. So tip number one, automatically add stuff when a task is created that's always the same. All the custom field selections, do that automatic. Don't do that by hand. Way too much work. Tip number one, save yourself a whole bunch of time. Tip number two, moving task based on stages. What does that mean? There's videos from your YouTube idea to in the works to videos have been completed and published. Now, as you have seen in the old video where I talk about my content creation workspace right here, we have stages in here from idea to prep to record to edit to SEO to scheduling to publishing. Use these stages to move your tasks so you don't have to move through these different lists and they automatically move. So when you look into my automations, what you're gonna see is multiple different moves, meaning when the stage changes to record, no matter where the task is, it moves it to in the works because now we're working on it. I need to record this thing, so let's move it in the works. Same thing when the stage changes to scheduled, move it into the published list because I'm done. It's all good. It's fine. It's published or it's going to be published. We don't have to worry about it. There is no specific list for scheduled versus published. It's just published. Now there's another one that fits right in here. So let's go create it. When our custom field, because our stages is a custom field, changes to, and you can get more specific when it changes from to. In this case, I don't care. It really just matters which stage it's in. It doesn't matter where it's coming from. And not the brain power. We need the video stages. So when the video stage changes to scheduled, then change the status to complete. Because the moment the video is uploaded to YouTube and I don't have to deal with it, it can be marked complete. It's done. I don't have to deal with it. Ding! That easy. So tip number two, move your tasks based on stages. And you even can take that a level up higher. If you're working with a team, assign the team member to the task that needs to take care of it in that stage. That's possible too. Now, tip number three is an Integromat automation and will save you hours on asset creation. Now, what do I mean by that? Now, when you're creating content, there's a whole stuff of asset management going on. You need to file your videos, your scripts, all of the stuff. So we are handling all of the assets in Google Drive because it's just the easiest way to do this. And it easily integrates with ClickUp. So we have my regular company syncing. We got the content 2021. We always work within a year. And within that year, we have our YouTube folder. Now in our folder structure, once you are in the YouTube folder, you have a folder for each and every single video we are putting out there. We have multiple folders in here. Some of those are manually created by my team. I'm adding these to the automation so they don't have to spend the time. But in general, I need a raw folder where all of my stuff goes in, everything that I'm recording, as well as my script outline. I have a specific template for my scripts that I'm going with, and I need all the stuff getting built. Now that's where most of the time goes, and I don't really, and then you are dropping and you don't want to do and you forget about it. So, ta-da! We are using Integromat to do that. Now, Integromat watches ClickUp tasks, meaning every time in my ClickUp space, there's a new task in my content creation, this thing triggers. It then filters it and it only goes by my stage of record, meaning all the prep has been done, all the research has been done, I am ready to record. That means I did all the prep work, right? Again, I did all the prep work, all the information is already in my ClickUp. I know what this thing is gonna be called, I have the tags in there, I have my SEO in there, all of this is done, I'm ready to record. That's where this thing triggers. Now, when this triggers, and we have a task that says record in it, it creates a Google Drive folder based on the naming convention in ClickUp, meaning it creates a folder in the location of, as you can see, you've just seen this whole folder location in the company folder for my content 2021, meaning in next year, I need to change this location. And it automatically creates the naming convention of the episode number and the task name. So let's make sure episode right in here. The next one is going to be 85. So we have that. We have the title right here. We have the episode number right here. It needs that to really generate this file and have the right naming convention. Cool, that's done. It then routes it. One thing, it is going back to ClickUp to add the URL of this folder into the ClickUp task, as well as creating another folder, which is the raw folder for all of my files right in there. And it copies the Google Docs template that I have to create that within that folder. So I have my script ready, my script template ready for that video. So let's run this puppy. How about that? So now if I take this video we are recording right now and I set the video stage ready to record and we let it do all of its magic. Now what happens when you run this scenario is it goes through these steps. As you can see right here, 3 easy automations to simplify your social media content process. It then created that folder. It then split it up to add that custom field link to my ClickUp, get the raw folder set up and get the script set up, which then means right in here, easy automations, naming convention based on the task. It built the raw folder for me so I can dump all of my content, videos, screen, all of the things right in here. It has the document ready for me with my framework for the video, so I just have to fill in the actual information and ready to go. Now, how long does it usually take you to create these assets and build the folder and do all the things? Because why would Google Drive have a simple duplicate the whole file structure button? It doesn't, right? So here is tip number 3, create all of your assets based on a specific data point right in ClickUp using Integromat. And you can go even crazier with this. There's so much more you can do. Go have fun with it. Enjoy. I'll see you in the next video when we talk more about making content creation really easy. And don't forget, subscribe and hit the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. I'll see you there. We'll be right back.